I think you want. We all want. Because we are willing to be a healthy person. We want to be comfortable and fit also. So, there are some reasons or some factors which factors are controlling the healthy or the fit body. How is it possible? So, first factor is the environment. If our environment is good or clean, on that time we will be healthy. Next, I want to talk about the nutritious food. Yes, if you will have the nutritious food daily, then you will be a healthy person. And if you will do the exercise daily, then also you will be a healthy person. And on that time, side by healthy person, your immunity power also will be boosted. And in this way, we can be a healthy person and a fit person. But after adopting these all the things, these all factors, sometimes it happens that we become sick, isn't it? For that time, what should we do? What the ways we can follow? On that time, we have to go for our medical science. Our medical science will save us, isn't it? So, on that time, we have to go to a doctor. So, first we will talk about the different needs of the medical science. Nowadays, do you know that our medical science has progressed very well? There is a tremendous progress. Do you know it? So, we have to know about the different field of the medical science, how they developed and the different new instruments, how they invented also. And in our country, there are thousands of medicines available, and most of them are because of fighting against different kind of diseases. So first I want to talk about the wonderful instruments. Different kind of wonderful instrument. First thing, it is coming the doctor's thermometer. It is very important for all of us, because doctor's thermometer, what it is doing actually, what it do for you and me, it is telling you the temperature, our body temperature. And here I am saying that the doctor's thermometer, the another name of the doctor's thermometer is the clinical thermometer or medical thermometer also. Actually, it is dictating our body temperature. How is it possible? Inside the thermometer, there is a tube, very small tube and thin also. So, with the help of and inside the tube, there should be some thermometric liquids, just like the alcohols or the mercury. So, what the liquids are doing, they are expanding whenever our body temperature is being high. Whenever the liquids are seeing, actually they are feeling that the temperature is high. Actually, what they are doing, the liquids, those kind of thermometric liquids, they are being expanded whenever in little amount of heat. By application of little amount of heat, they are getting expand. So whenever our body temperature are more, on that time they can feel. So on that time they are being expanded, and as a result of it, we are able to see our body temperature. And one more thing, how can we measure it? We put it orally or otherwise in underarm or any other auxiliary points of our body. In this way, we are able to get the body temperature. But there is a problem also. What problem? The mercury, which one I told you, that one is very toxic in nature. And sometimes it happens that the breaking of the thermometer, yes, it happens very frequently for all of one new thermometer, and that one is little bit costly also. So that's why we are nowadays we are not using those kind of thermometer. Nowadays we are using the infrared radiated thermometer. Infrared radiated, that one is a one kind of wave, and with the help of or for that kind of thermometer, do you know, no need to touch your body. If you will keep it pure centimeter or just like this kind of, see here, this kind of distance, so it is able to measure our body temperature. And why we should use this? In our forehead or our eardrums, there, that means the this kind of infrared radiated thermometer, it is able to measure our body temperature. And one more thing, there is a two kind of scale. Our body temperature, now you can ask me that which one is the body temperature, how can, yes, I will measure the body temperature, but which one is the correct and which one is wrong, how can I understand? Our normal body temperature is 98.6 degree Fahrenheit or 37 degree Celsius. This Fahrenheit and Celsius, these two are the scale. With the help of these two scale, generally we are measuring our body temperature. And if your body temperature is below these two reading, that means you don't have fever. And if the temperature, that means body temperature, is more than these two temperature, that means you goes higher peak fever, you have fever. So definitely you have to keep in mind. So whenever our body temperature reads, the instrument, the thermometer reads above these two level, that means that one, anyone, if your thermometer can read the Fahrenheit scale, that means on that time 98.6 degree Fahrenheit, or if your thermometer can able to measure the Celsius reading, so anyhow no problem, but that one should be this point. If below the reading, below that temperature, you don't have any fever. And if the body temperature becomes higher than that, on that time you have fever, you have to consult doctor. And in the nowadays we have two kind of thermometer. One is analog and another one is digital. So what the analog and the digital are doing? Actually, analog thermometer, they are able to show the reading. Show the reading, that means how much distance the liquid expands, you have to see, you have to read like that. But for the case of, see here, the reading of the analog thermometer, see here, the mercury column, it went up to here, that's why here the analog thermometer is giving the reading up to here. But for the case of digital thermometer, it will give you your body temperature in a number. So no need to read how to read, no complication. So there you have to simply read the number. How much reading should be there, that one is your body temperature. So it can read, both of them can read, but one of their showing, the analog is showing and the digital, it is giving the number, the numericals also it is able to give. And in the year of, now you can ask me that from where this thermometer came, who invented the thermometer? This is, see here, have a look, is Daniel Gabriel Fahrenheit. Yes, you can notice one thing, in the name of the last part of the name, Fahrenheit is there. In honor of him, the scale, the Fahrenheit scale, now only I have told you that Fahrenheit scale, they put it as Fahrenheit. So, who is the inventor of the thermometer? Daniel Gabriel Fahrenheit. In the year of 1714, he invented the thermometer. That one was the small glass, already I have told you that one is nothing but a small glass. inside the glass one very thin, very narrow tube should be there, and into that one bulb should be there. Inside the bulb, the thermometric liquids, just like alcohol or the mercury, should be placed, and whenever it will come in high temperature, it will expand its volume, and as a result of it, it can measure the temperature. So this one is the all about our doctor's thermometer or clinical thermometer or medical thermometer, whatever you may call. So we learn about the thermometer, and do you know one thing, that thermometer was invented first by Galileo Galilei. He was an astronomer and he is from Italy. In the year of 1593, he invented the thermometer, but the thermometer metric liquid, which one he used, that one was water. And one more thing, you can ask me that where did he bought our Fahrenheit, sir? That means the Daniel Gabriel Fahrenheit, he bought in Poland. Now I want to talk about the stethoscope. What the stethoscope is doing for us? Actually, it is telling us the heartbeat. How is it possible? With the help of multiple reflection of sound. Which sound is being there? That sound is passed through the stethoscope. See here, have a look. Stethoscope is looking like this. This one. And you may ask, who invented it? René Linac. René Linac, he invented the stethoscope first. But how he invented, that one is a one story. First, on that time, what he did, he used to see the heartbeat. How? With the help of one wooden pipe. See here, have a look here. In the year of 1816, he made a cylinder from several sheets of paper. With the help of different sheets of paper, he formed one cylinder and used his patient. He used that thing to different patients. He was a doctor in profession, so that's why he can do. And he discovered that internal sound. On that time, he first understood that the internal sound, that means our body sounds, that means first thing, whenever body sound means, our heartbeat will come first. So our internal body sound, he have seen that the it could hear it with the help of that wooden like structure. So that means the tube like structure, which one on that time he did with the help of one tube, and that one also is called the lathe. Lathe, L-A-T-H-E, lathe. So this on that time only he discovered, but he told that no, that kind of invention he didn't named as first the stethoscope. He told that one is the medicate or auscultation. Medicate auscultation. He named his invention as medicate auscultation. Afterwards, his colleagues means who was working with him, they convinced him that no, the name which invention you did, that should be the stethoscope, because that one is a Greek word and the meaning of the word stethoscope. See here, stethoscope. The stetho means that one is the chest. The meaning of the stetho is chest, and the scope means the view. With the help of that instrument, we are able to see the chest, that means inside. We are able to view it. So that's why the name should be the stethoscope. And in the year of 1819, he also agreed with him. That means them. So, the stethoscope is nothing. one is used for to understand the body congestion of the lungs and the irregular heart pulse also it is telling us. And the nurses, they are used this instrument to regulate, to know about the restoring blood flow of any patient's body. And the while measuring the blood pressure, they used generally. And nowadays, you know that all the doctors uses the stethoscope.